I wanted to do you a quick video today about some new bits of equipment that I've got for the workshop. So I won't be making anything. It's just going to help you out if you kind of find that your workshop's expanding a little bit. And what I want to talk about is some new boxes that I've got for sort of organising all your bits and pieces in. Now, when I first started in leatherwork, like everybody does, you know, you think, oh, I'll have a go at this. And you buy a few tools and stuff and you end up buying, you know, one type of press stud and a couple of types of rivets and stuff. And what you do is you generally get one of these little boxes that have little compartments in, and you put everything in a box and think, there we go, that's, you know, that's really neat. And then things progress a little bit and you find you've got, you know, three or four different types of rivets and a couple of different types of press studs, and these aren't big enough, so you get another box and then another box. And this is what I did, to the point where you have a few little boxes, and then you get to the point where you go, right, I've got too many little boxes. So what I then did is moved on to one of these things where you have like a, you know, you have like a set of drawers and you have 24 or 36 or however many of these little plastic drawers that you slide in, and they have little dividers in that move up and down, and you can put it on the wall or whatever you want to do. So that's what I did. I put everything in the thing on the wall, and then you fill that up and you think, right, this is as big as I'll ever need. And then eventually it's not big enough and so on. Now there's several things that I don't really like about these little drawers as well, which is probably where, if you've been doing it for a while, most people are at, you've got these little drawers. They're never quite big enough. So if you try and put, you know, the four parts of a press stud in these, you know, where they line these bits up, they're never quite big enough. The little things tend to slide out unless you glue them in, which means if you've then separated all your parts out, you know, you knock it and all the parts spill together. They're a bit difficult to kind of see exactly what you've got in terms of stock. You know, if you're ordering, you have to kind of pull every drawer out and think, oh, have I got enough of those? Have I got enough of those? They're a bit fiddly for labelling. I printed all different labels. You can see even this one, I've written one on in pen and stuck a label on, and then if that's not right and that's not right, you're peeling it off. And they're just sort of not ideal, you know. So I would think that's what a lot of people have got. And they work okay, but there's better things you can get. So I was watching a video the other day with Adam Savage off Mythbusters. And it was like a tour of his you know, his workshop, because he does obviously special effects and stuff. And the video was showing you how he organises all his bits and pieces that he uses for making stuff in his workshop. And the stuff that he was using is this Sortimo stuff, which is what I'm going to show you. When I saw it, I thought, oh, you know, I bet that could be really good for leatherwork stuff. So I bought some, and I think it's really good, which is why I want to show it to you. So put those to the side. So this is an example of one of the boxes. Now, this stuff as well, I'm showing you can get, you know, they sell it sort of all over the world. I think you can certainly buy it in America and Europe and places like that. So if you do decide you want some of this stuff, it's also shouldn't be difficult for you to get, which is another good thing about it. So as far as I'm concerned, having now bought some of this and set it all up, this is a sort of ultimate evolution of these sorts of cheap boxes that you can buy, is this stuff. Now, the only negative point to it is that it is quite expensive, but I really do think that you're getting good quality for what you're paying for. But apart from that, I really don't have a bad word to say about it, to be honest. I'll show you a little bit sort of what it is and how it works in case it's something that you're interested in yourselves. So this is, I think, primarily aimed at, well, to be honest, it's not primarily aimed at that. You can use it in workshops and things, but what they have a lot on the website and what they show you is it's for vans. So if you've got like a big, you know, a big work van or a transit van, they sell all this kind of racking that bolts into the back of your van, and then all this stuff, because there's whole catalogues full of all these different things. It kind of all fits into the van. So if you look on the website, you'll think it does look a bit like a van outfit thing, but there's nothing to stop you using the boxes wherever you like, you know, in normal workshops. So these particular boxes that I'm going to show you today, what they're called T-BOXXs. They've got all different kinds of boxes. Some are metal, some are plastic, some are bigger, some are smaller, and so on. But these ones that I found to be the best for this are what they're called T-BOXXs. So that's the actual box, you know, the design of the box itself. And then what you have basically within each box is you've got a number of different types of inserts. And all the inserts are kind of multiples of these single units. So you can see on the lid, they've got sort of this grid system, and when you close the lid, it locks everything into place. And you're probably thinking, oh, yeah, I've seen that before on like a cheap box. To be honest, I've got like boxes with screws and stuff in that are supposed to do this, and if you tip it upside down, it doesn't, you know, it doesn't really keep everything together. You don't want to trust them. You kind of cringe if it goes upside down. These ones do lock absolutely perfectly upside down. I've got no qualms about shaking hundreds of rivets upside down. Everything will stay exactly as it is. There's no gaps in this or anything, or where anything migrates. Everything sits exactly where it should do. So that locks it in the lid, and then underneath, in the bottom, there's kind of little holes, and then there's little feet on each of the boxes. So all the boxes basically lock top and bottom and don't go anywhere. So if you take some boxes out and then close this, these don't move into that hole or anything. Everything stays exactly where it's supposed to be. So that works really well. And then what they've also got is they've got different sizes of boxes. So for example, obviously the red ones are single ones, the yellow ones there are double ones. If you look in this other box, you'll see that there's also a blue one there, that's like a 4, and a green one, that's a 6. And I think they do an orange one, which you don't have any of, which is like a full length one. And they also do ones that are like full strips. So there's all these different kinds of sizes of inserts you can get. And you can basically line them up however you want. So however you want to sort of logically store all your stuff, you can use the different boxes to get everything lined up exactly how you want it. And you know, if you change your mind about how you organise something, you can just move everything around, which is difficult to do with those little drawers. You know, you're kind of limited to just lining the drawers up, whereas with this, you can get everything just exactly where you want it. So when you buy these as well, you can buy them either empty and then buy all your own inserts to go in them, or you can buy them already full of stuff and then use them how you like. And when you buy them full, there's different sort of standard setups you can get. So you can get one, for example, that's all full of these little red ones. You can get one that's all full of the yellow ones. You can get one that's a mixture where you get a couple of green, some blue, some red, and so on. So what you need to do really, if you do want to get a few, is plan out what you think you might need and then try and buy the boxes that are full. Because if you buy the empty box and then just the inserts cost you a lot more than if you buy one that's already full. So that it's worth thinking about trying to get them, you know, when they're already, I've already got the parts in. They also sell half height boxes as well. So these are sort of full depth ones. And what the boxes do is the boxes actually stack together. So you can see that those two lock together. So what you can buy is you can buy ones that are half the height. So if if everything, like, I like it like this, so I can sort of glance and see stock levels of things. But if you wanted to kind of double up your space and everything was just half full, you could also buy the half height ones and then have two layers if you wanted to do that as well. The other thing you can get, which is very handy, especially when you've got a lot of distinct parts like this, is that they have this labelling system. Hopefully you can see that there. So you can buy these little plastic kind of jackets with sticky backs, and what you do is you peel them off the sheet and stick them there. And then you can also buy these little card inserts, which are just perforated. Obviously if you've run out of these, you could make your own. So as opposed to the little drawers where you write on it or you stick on it and you change your mind and you're either crossing it out or trying to peel your stickers off, with these you can just make a new piece of card. Or you know, if you sort of think, oh, this box isn't big enough, move to a bigger box, you can just pull the card out, pop it in the other sleeve and so on. So certainly for labelling, they're a lot neater as well. So I'll tell you what I've got in these, just in case, you know, you are sort of a professional or semi-professional workshop and trying to work out how many you might need if you want to buy some. Whether you've got more or less bits and pieces than I have, it might give you just an idea of what you need. So this first box here is basically rivets. So I've got a few types of copper rivets, and then I've got rivets by the colour and by the size. So I've got the, obviously, nickel, antique, brass, brass and black. These are all tandy bits, these. And then sizes ranging from the really tiny ones, extra small, up to the large. So if you get a fair selection of those, then the rivets basically fill a box. I don't have many types of copper rivets because they're expensive and I don't use them that much. There's a few of those at the front. So this box is press studs. So that whole side there, that's basically line 20s and line 24s. Obviously you've got four parts to each one, nickel, brass and black, so that fills half of the thing up. I've got Segma snaps, glove snaps, pull the dots, and then the back I've got these little fancy line 24 heads, and then that's actually just got contours in there, so they're kind of related. So again, basically, if you get a few varieties, then snaps, press studs will also fill an entire box. This box is eyelets and fixing stuff. So I've got machine screws, little eyelets, big eyelets that I never really use, Kydex eyelets, they're Sam Brown studs, washers, tech locks, run out of small tech locks, and they're all Chicago screws there. So that's sort of general eyelets and fixing hardware. Again, that fills another box. And this final box is sort of general loop hardware and so on. So I've got obviously D-rings, square strap loops, O's, which I never use very much, bag clasps, keyring type bits, clips, and then again this size just buckles, so different sizes of buckles. So my last box is sort of general general fixing hardware and so on. So I've basically got four boxes. I actually bought five boxes, and the last one's just got spare bits in like blades and stuff. But in terms of general hardware, I've basically managed to fill about four boxes, and I've got some expansion room if I need it. So the last thing that I'll show you is just a little drawer that I bought to store these in. Now, you can buy these kind of special units for these, and on the side, they've basically got these kind of rails built into the side of the box. There's a couple of different things you can buy. You can buy one that's like a shelf, that they're just... you push in and sit down, it's like basically a normal shelf. And what I really wanted is they have like a rails unit. So what you do is you put all these in as high as you want, and then what you can do then is you pull the shelf out, and it pulls all the way out, and these are locked in. So basically you can pull it out, and then while the shelf's out, you can lift the lid up, get what you want out, and put it away again without putting these in and out. Unfortunately, I couldn't afford that because they are really expensive. So what I did was I just got some little shelves from IKEA, which were really cheap, which I'll just show you now. So this is the shelving unit that I got from IKEA. This is like super cheap. I think it was £25, and I think it came with two shelves. I think I bought two extra shelves, and I think they were £5. They're probably £35 for the whole thing. And these fit quite nicely in the gaps. It doesn't waste too much space. Obviously, it's slightly wider than it needs to be, but that works quite well for the money. Certainly, as I say, the Sortimo pull out one, I think it was over £300, because it is designed as like a van fitting, as I say, and it's like super industrial vehicle fittings. Just really wasn't worth the money for me for here. Obviously, if you're good at woodwork, you could always build yourself something if you want, but I'm not. So I think that works quite well, doesn't waste much space, and I'll basically just pull out whichever box I want to use. So I hope that might have been useful for you. As I say, this is the best stuff that I've found after quite a few years of messing about. So whilst I obviously don't suggest that you just start leather work and then run out and spend a lot of money on these, because you won't fill them for years, if you've been at it a few years and you're thinking, no, I've got stuff everywhere, then it is worth thinking about investing in these, because they are extremely good quality. You can sort of line them up to your little OCD heart's content, swap them around, fiddle with your labels, and it's actually... If you enjoy neatly lined up stuff like I do, it's actually quite enjoyable getting everything organised, and there's a certainly a pleasure in sort of sitting back and thinking, yep, I know where everything is, I know exactly what I've got, and I can change it whenever I like. So hopefully that might have been of use to somebody.